Hello. Now, I want to talk to you about a dilemma you might face, probably not, but in case you do, what would you do if you developed Alzheimer's or old age dementia? And you were living by yourself, you didn't have any family, in subsidized housing. Now I have family, four kids, descendants, I hope if I develop old age dementia, they'll recognize it, although they might not, I don't know. Now, I have a cousin who developed Alzheimer's in his 70s, but, well, not luckily for him, but luckily for his family, he was a multimillionaire. And he was in politics, had a prominent role in playing in politics. So when he developed Alzheimer's, though, there was plenty of money to take care of him. And it was, you know, very, very difficult, but it's been manageable. But I, now, he is my cousin on my mother's side, and his own mother did have apparently the kind of Alzheimer that he has. Even though there's Alzheimer in my side of that family, it is apparently not quite as early to manifest, or might not be as bad. So hopefully I'm lucking out, because I'm going to be 87 this summer. If Alzheimer is going to make an appearance, I happen to think I'm still pretty sharp for 86. And that's a good sign. I'm the oldest, too. Now, I don't know if you know it or not, but the oldest child of the oldest child of the oldest child, which I am, that child is going to be the healthiest and live the longest, in my experience, of any of the kids. Because the parents are young, strong, healthy. They haven't been worn down by marriage and having kids. So the first kid they have, they're probably going to, and everybody's going to dote on that kid, and he might, or she might get the best chance to grow old successfully, meaning healthy, very healthy, strong. And in our day, when after they'd had 14 kids or something like that, they might have brain damage, because it was perceived in those days that after all those years of marriage and all those kids, the woman and the man didn't have what it takes any longer to produce a totally healthy child, normal, then that's when they would be very apt to have a, you know. But lest it be thought cruel, I don't want to emphasize this, because, you know, people give people who develop dementia, no matter for when they came along, they're cruel enough to them. So, I am thinking about what you could possibly do when you're not hitting on all cylinders. Now, I have two sisters, and the three of us, we spend certain time checking each other out to see if we see any sign of dementia creeping in. Let's see. Did you notice that she said this, that? Uh-oh, what does that mean? And, of course, me, I'm sure they discuss me and see whether I'm showing any signs, those dreaded signs of dementia. And, you know, if my brain begins to malfunction, there won't be a thing I can do about it. If it doesn't, I'll just be plain lucky. And I hope I am. But, just in case, I do have to. Now, my ex-husband started showing signs of Alzheimer's because he had it in his family. And, but I was no longer responsible for him. He wasn't married to me. And so, I could just, not my problem, because I couldn't take care of him. I mean, I couldn't do anything with him if I'd wanted to. But, if I happen, if that happens to be my lot, to help somebody with Alzheimer's, who doesn't have anybody, or showing signs of possible, I can't think of a worse predicament to be in. Imagine how long you'd last on the street with Alzheimer's. Ooh. And I'm sure there are people out there with it. And or even, you know, mental illness that they've inherited. So those people sometimes end up on the street and have to fend for themselves, survive the worst possible circumstances that anybody could cope with, and they're not even all there. So this gives you something to think about and be thankful for if you don't have those signs. Because that might be like a living hell. Could be. So, anyway, that's what I was thinking about today. It's Memorial Day. And so I think that rather than pay too much attention to those who are dead or been long dead in my family who were lost in the war, I'm going to think about the ones that are up against it right now. Like my uncle, who is an uncle also to my cousin who has Alzheimer's. I'm sure that he wants us to think about him living a kind of death of the brain, of who he was. Boy, that must be tough, because he's probably got a dim sense as it starts fading. Well, I just can't even imagine. And I'm sure that my uncle, who's lost in World War II, is thinking about those in the family that are really experiencing trauma, because in his case, money doesn't make a whole lot of difference, except that you can hire people to watch, help you watch out for that person. So I'm thinking how about those people too who are losing people to this disease. And I thought, well, they haven't conquered it yet. They haven't been able to stop what they claim, deposits on the brain that blot out your senses to the point that you're no longer what you might say sane. Oh boy. And a friend of mine right now is showing signs. And I'm thinking, because, you know, living in a family where you've been watching for signs for years, I hope I'm not seeing signs, because this person is not in a good position to have Alzheimer's or old age dementia. Not at all. But is anybody ever in a good place that losing their minds might not be too traumatic? Yeah, it helps if there's money to hire caretakers if need be. But I don't know. That might not be the greatest solution in the world either. It bears thinking about. Think about it. People in subsidized housing. Boy. Yes. Need to think about that too. And how they might help their neighbors if they develop it. Something to think about. Victims of Alzheimer's. Friends of Alzheimer's, people with Alzheimer's. So that's who I choose to think about on this day.